Thank you. Rashad, I appreciate it.
Thank you.
So what exactly is in the Green New Deal, or do we have to pass it to find out? Mark Stein is paying close attention to this. He joins us tonight. Mark, what do you make of the Green New Deal?
Well, actually, just to pick up on Rashad's point, if you accept that carbon is bad, and I don't particularly, there's a contradiction between the Green New Deal and open borders, which the Democrats are also committed to, because the average person in the Western world has a carbon footprint 30 times the size of everyone, of somebody in, say, Somalia. So instead of moving everyone from Somalia to Minnesota, we would be better off actually moving everyone in Minnesota to Somalia. And I certainly hope that is in Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's next draft of her Green New Deal.
I just want to point out to our viewers what you're watching on the screen, I don't know if you can see it, Mark, is the president arriving in El Paso, Texas for an event scheduled, I think, at the bottom of this hour. So, but that's, I mean, you just point out, Mark Stein, a really, I think, important contradiction in this whole worldview, which is you're not going to have a cleaner country with open borders, not because immigrants are inherently dirty, I'm not saying that, but because overcrowded countries are dirty countries, period, always.
Well, and they don't think about the way these things piece together. Now, the disappointment for me in what happened with your guest on Friday night, for example, is that I disagree with Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, but she's 29 years old, and I thought she was sincere and idealistic and earnest. She's been in Washington for 2 weeks. I think she took her seat just a couple of weeks ago, and she's already become one of these sleazy operators whose minders are finding out, are fanning out and denying reality and saying that she didn't misspoke. She deplores this campaign spreading false stories. She's becoming, in effect, the governor of Virginia, withdrawing things he's actually said and done.
That's totally true.
The fact is, this draft sat on her website for 2 days, I believe, until I think it was NPR who were first to report it. Obviously, it's a first draft. When she says she's in favor of remaking every building in America, that's the first draft. The second draft says that while every building in America is being remodeled, we're all going to be moved into tent cities in Californian towns to live in while she's remodeling all our homes. I'm disappointed that she's not sufficiently idealistic to stand by the plain utopian nonsense of her original proposal.
I think it's a really fair point, and I would at least, I would respect that. She should be more direct. Mm. That's right. People give you credit for that. No,
absolutely.
It's totally fair. Mark Stein, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Tuck.